Hello and welcome to InvestComics TV. I'm Jay Katz, your host, along with Lazaro Suarez. Welcome to InvestComics TV, Lazaro.
Thank you for having me. Thank you.
First question, we want to know is a little bit about yourself. Tell us a little bit about you.
Well, I'm originally from Miami, Florida. Born and raised. I moved up to West Palm in 2001. And I am currently an artist, comic book artist, painter, penciler, and I also write my own comic book called My Date with the Devil's Daughter.
Very nice. Okay, so you're an artist and a writer. When did that all start taking place where you knew, like when you were like a year old, you started drawing stick figures, or what happened?
It pretty much did start when I was young. Probably my elementary school year, the exact years, I don't know, but probably when I was like, 10 or 11 or something like that. I started drawing and all that, and I just started developing my skills, just got drawing pretty much into comic books. My favorite artist back then was Ron Lim and the Silver Surfer. Yes. And I just started, wanting to do comic books ever since then,
So do you find yourself trying to, look after Ron Lim still today? Because he was awesome as a Silver Surfer artist, I remember that, Ron.
Yeah, and then when he left, I forgot about him. But currently my influences now are Frank Rosetta, which he passed away.
Yes.
But I also enjoy Adam Hughes and any of the Kubert brothers, Adam, Andy, and their dad, Joe Kubert. Any of them, those are my inspirations right now.
Very nice. You do a lot of shows, a lot of conventions. Have you ever met any of the people that you really like to look at and try to inspire your inspirations? Have you ever met any of them?
No, I never got the nerve to meet any of them. I did. One of my inspirations was at a convention at MegaCon, Jeff Scott Campbell. Okay. He was at MegaCon, and I wanted to meet him, but it was so packed at the event, I never got a chance to do that. So.
Right. Okay, that's cool. So you do shows, obviously, correct?
Yes, any show I get my hands into, I try to do.
Oh, really? Okay, that's cool. What was the last show that you did?
Big one or a little small?
Oh, it doesn't matter. Big, little, doesn't matter.
I did free comic book day at Crossword Comics in Broward County. I did that one. The last big one was MegaCon. And yeah, those were the last two I did.
Oh, that's cool. So you did the last one at the free comic book day. Where was that?
At Crossword Comics and Games. It's on Lauderhill. It's in Lauderhill on University.
Okay. In Florida? Yeah.
I'm sorry?
In Florida, right?
Yeah, in Florida.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay, cool. All right, so on free comic book day, were you doing sketches, or what were you doing exactly? Just meet and greet, or what?
Part meet and greet, part sketches. I was promoting the comic book, honestly, and I was doing sketches for people that would come by and wanted sketches. I was showcasing my artworks, too. I brought my portfolio down there and have people take a look and gander at it and give out my business cards in case anyone wanted to contact me for commissions and stuff like that.
Cool. So what do you find yourself, what's one of your favorite things that you like to really sketch? One of your favorite sketches that you like to do that you really feel you can nail down that you really like to do?
Just like one of my favorite influences, Adam Hughes, I like to do the female pinup art.
Okay.
I really like to do that kind of art. Yeah, pretty much that's pretty much what most of my portfolio has currently.
Yes, and anybody that follows you on Facebook, definitely will see some of those those pictures that you draw of the female. And you do a very great, it's a great job. They're very nice pictures that you do.
Thank you.
No problem. So basically, you have a comic book that you do that is called the...
My Date with the Devil's Daughter.
Yes, okay. Now, as far as that goes, how did this name come up, like that name? Like, how did that happen?
It's just one of those things that I just thought, you know, that would be a cool name for a comic. I don't know why I came up with that name. And then, to be honest with you, I didn't have a story, I didn't have characters, I just had the title, and I just wanted a story from that title, and okay. Just developed it.
Alright, so you basically had the title first, and then you went to the comic book.
Yes.
Well, that's very interesting. Okay, that's cool. Alright, let's take our first break, and then when we come back, we'll talk a little bit more about your comic book, alright? And welcome back to InvestComics TV. We are here with Lazaro, and we are going to continue with the My Date with the Devil's Daughter. I wanted to know about, as far as character development goes, who are the characters, who are the main players, and how did they really come into your head and to draw them, to give them their personality? How did that all happen?
Well, the main character is Josh Allen, and he's a typical young guy who, you know, he's going to college, and then he gets a note saying that his parents died. So on his way, like, he goes to attend the funeral, and later on he finds out that he's actually the son of what I'm calling evocators, and they are a group of people that could summon demons. Sort of a sense, and throughout the story, he pretty much tries to solve the mystery of what happened to his parents, and also finding out that the small town of Safe Haven, which the story takes place, is endangered by some renegade demon, and he gets the help of someone that's seen him. The only person that Satan trusts, which is his own daughter, and her name is Samantha.
Okay.
And together they try to stop the evil demon whose name is Folklore to stop making, because what Folklore wants to do is create another hell.
Okay.
He steals an ancient relic and he wants to create another hell, but Satan doesn't want that.
Right.
So it's a whole battle to save the souls of Safe Haven, save the world pretty much.
Sure,
so,
right. That's pretty neat. Okay, so how many books do we only have one shot out right now? Do we have two or three books? What do we have going
right
on?
Now, yeah, right now we got one issue in publication right now. Hopefully getting up to two more by the end of the year.
Wow.
How far the series? It's actually going to be a series. With some fillers in between, you know, to like not really. Part of the main stories, but just, you know, little stories, little nibbits here and there to still entertain and to still develop the characters a little bit more. And I don't know how long it's gonna run, so it's just going with the flow. I know how I wanted to start and how I wanted to end. It's just getting the fillers in there, and that's a work in progress right now.
Do you ever see yourself, because right now you're the artist and writer, the inker, correct? You do everything, basically, for the book.
Yeah.
Do you ever feel like you're going to summon for some help? Or do you just see this as a solo project for now?
I would take as much help as I can right now. The funds right now isn't letting me do that.
Sure.
Resources. So I'm doing as much as I can, getting the word out, and if people want to help with the inking and some of the story and some of the dialogue, and actually what I really want to do as well is part of the fillers, the fillers I was talking about,
uh-huh.
You know, that part that doesn't have to do with the main story. If any writer out there wants to do something with my characters, they could jump in and do an issue or two with a filler and you know, get their work out.
Absolutely. And how can they contact you by email, or how would they get a hold of you that way?
Email, yeah, you could email me. My email is graphicd@bellsouth.net. You can contact me there by email. I got a Facebook page, Team Amazing at Art of Lazaro Suarez. You can contact me there too.
And what's Team Amazing? What's that all about?
It was a little high school joke that we came up with, me and my friends in high school. We just took this, we were out at, what was it, Disney, Orlando, outside of the hotel that we were staying at. And we just took, we just asked some guy to take a picture of us, and we just decided, let's do some superhero pose. And so we just did some weird superhero pose, like, out of our heads. And it came out so awesome, and we just called ourselves Team Amazing.
Okay.
And I kind of kept the name for myself because I thought it was an awesome name.
That is a pretty funny name, actually. All right, so cool. So I always see you on Facebook. So that's really a good place to contact you on Facebook. What name are you under as far as the Facebook? Are you under your name or...
I do have my own personal Facebook. It's, you know, just Lazaro Suarez. And then I have my separate art page that people can just like. That way, you know, you don't have to look at each other's personal information. If you just like my art, you know, you
sure.
can just, like that group. And it's, Team Amazing, Art of Lazaro Suarez.
Awesome. Okay. So, as far as your, the comic goes, my date with the Devil's Daughter, where can we find that book? Can we buy it online? Can we go to the comic book store? Where do we find the book? Or how can we get a hold of it?
Right now, you could, if you want to get it online, you can go to indieplanet.com. They have, it's print on demand, you know, they'll print it for you and they'll ship it out. If you want to go to a local store, I got them at Past, Present, Future Comics. I got some issues there.
Where is Past, Present, Future, Florida?
Yeah, Florida,
okay.
In West Palm Beach, Florida,
okay.
Off of Military Trail, between Okeechobee and Belvedere.
Okay.
I got one at Mike's Florida Super Comics.
Okay.
In Broward County, Florida. I got one at, and I also got them at Tate's.
Okay.
Tate's at Broward County, what is it, Lauderhill, is it? Florida.
Yes, I believe so. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, in Broward County. He actually has signed copies of them. He asked me to sign them and to put them up on the show. So actually signed copies of them at his store.
At Tate's?
And, I'm sorry?
At Tate's, you have signed copies of the book.
At Tate's, yeah.
Is it the cover price, though, or are we going to pay extra for this?
Whatever you sign up for, but
yeah.
You know, I'm assuming cover price.
Yeah, I think should be.
That's at his discretion. but other than that, you know, if they don't have them there or you know, online, you know, you could always go to the conventions. I'm going to be at Florida Super Comics. You know, he has his free comic book day every Saturday. And I'm going to be there on the 21st.
Okay.
And I'm also going to, he let me set up there. And of course there's, Florida SuperCon on 4th of July weekend. I'm
right.
in Miami, Florida. So I'm going to be there as well.
And that's, the first, the second, third, and the fourth, correct? He added an extra day there, didn't he?
Yes, and I'm going to be all out there all 4 days. I mean, he lets some people be there and leave on for only 3 days, but I'm planning on being there for all 4 days.
Cool, okay. So the next place we can catch you is when? This coming weekend?
This coming weekend at Florida Super Comics.
Cool.
May 21st.
All right. So I guess anybody in Florida or in the area, they should stop by and get some signed copies and some sketches maybe and check out your comic, right?
Yep. I'm going to have my sketches, my artwork, my comic book. My whole shebang is going to be down there. So.
All right. Cool. Oh, absolutely. All right. So we're going to wrap it up, Lazaro. And thank you so much for coming by. We enjoyed the time here at InvestComics TV.
Thank you for having me. Thank you.
All right. Take it easy.
You too. Thank you.
All right. I'm Jay Cass with InvestComics TV.